Now what pattern is this? This is a different pattern. You have septal thickening and a subpleural rim of maybe 2 millimeter sparing. More of ground glass. So intralobular septal thickening, no honeycombing, no traction bronchiectasis. What do you think this is?
NSIP.
Perfect. Non-specific interstitial pneumonia. And this was positive ANCA. So now we know this is NSIP. And this with positive, so some kind of a connective tissue disorder. And the pattern in that connective tissue disorder, just finding it NSIP-like. So what is NSIP? 80% have ground glass opacities, lack of honeycombing. We just discussed, there is no honeycombing, there is no traction bronchiectasis, and a differential diagnosis of NSIP, because NSIP alone can be just, the histopathology can be NSIP only, or it can be NSIP pattern. So NSIP pattern can be seen in mixed collagen vascular disorder. Like what I told you, a good HRCT, is this a good HRCT? No. Because there is a lot of non-compliance when it came to breath hold. Because this patient has dyspnea. So a lot of haziness is seen, even there is no sharpness to the findings that you are seeing of the ground glass opacity. When you report, if you don't get honeycombing but you are getting subpleural sparing of ground glass opacity and you get a little type of bronchiolitis or bronchiolectasia with ground glass but no honeycombing, then you can safely call this fibrotic pattern of NSIP. So you have a cellular pattern. The first case that I showed you was a cellular NSIP. Like this is a cellular, but you can have some amount of dilated bronchi. This could be a fibrotic NSIP. So you have two types. Now another case, multiple nodules seen in bilateral lung. Now these nodules are of ground glass density. Is there honeycombing? No. Is there ground glass? A little bit. Is there traction bronchiectasis? No. Is there interstitial septal thickening? No. So what is your diagnosis? Do you think it's a subacute HP? Yes. Hypersensitivity pneumonitis. Now, not many a times you image a acute HP. Most of the time, you image subacute HP, which you saw. These are centrilobular nodules scattered in bilateral lobes and most of them are more in the upper lobes, but they are also seen in the lower lobes. And you have a positive history. So you need history. Here you don't need the pathologist for, because you are not going to do a lung biopsy. But you need for BAL, bronchoscopy with lavage. You need the pathologist. That is why it is a multidisciplinary. And chronic HP, as I told you, goes into fibrosis. And the findings are similar to what you get in UIP pattern. The only thing in HP that you should remember is look if there are any areas of mosaic attenuation. You have a UIP pattern and you have black areas, that is black and white. That means there is some amount of air trapping. Usually, air trapping and UIP pattern points towards chronic HP. Safely can say that. I'm not talking about this. As I told you, you need the pathologist for this. So there is no escape of the three doctors that you need. So multiple cases. And this is increasing because of pigeon exposure. In rainy season, because of fungus in the small rooms that people are staying. So all these are exposure towards allergens. So these, if you can appreciate, these are small ground glass density nodules scattered in bilateral lung without any traction bronchiectasis or honeycombing. At least there are no lymph nodes. So this is most likely suggestive of subacute HP. But you need, of course, your pathologist or the microbiologist for serology. Now this is what I meant. If in a case where they are going to go into chronicity, you see something like this black area, that means there are areas of air trapping, which is commonly seen with HP. And this is the time where you need to do X-ray treatment, so that if this is attenuated, that means that it is exaggeration of the black area or exaggeration of mosaic pattern, that means there is air trapping. Again, so a poor quality HRCT, more upper lobe, so this is more of ground glass and multiple nodules. It is a difficult diagnosis to call it as a subacute HP, but the clinicians will definitely help, or you can give a positive challenge test if you know the patient is staying near an area where the pigeons are fed or there is dampness. Can take out the patient from that surrounding That is what the clinician is going to do. If you raise a possibility of a subacute HP, this is what the clinician is going to do. Now, chronic HP, as I told you, is similar to this. What is this? UIV pattern. Okay? Now again, another pattern. What do you have here? You want to call it NSIP, right? But this is not NSIP. So these are multiple consolidation of both with septal thickening and ground glassing. And this is in a correct setting. You should think when you have consolidations which are peripheral, not particularly in a particular lobe, more triangular, subpleural, think of cryptogenic organizing pneumonia, initially called as bronchiolitis oblique transorganizing pneumonia. Again, peripheral, whatever I have said is going to come. You can have mediastinal lymphadenopathy again here. You can have pleural effusion. Like in this case, there can be some amount of fever, but dry cough. In a given clinical setting, triangular base, multiple consolidations with septal thickening, again a consolidation, so multiple consolidations, not defined to one lobe. Think of cough.